In this video, we are going to take a look at some tools available to us in Autodesk Inventor to help us fix sketch and feature problems. To begin with, I have a shape here that perhaps I want to extrude or revolve, and in either case, when I choose the extrude or revolve command, it's prompting me to pick a profile, but you'll notice that it's not picking this solid shaded portion. And if I go ahead and click on the edge of something, you can see what's actually happening is it's creating a set of surfaces. So there's something about the sketch that Inventor does not like. It's not allowing me to make an extruded solid out of it. So let's look closer at that. I'll do the extrude again. And if I look in the upper right corner of the extrude dialog box, I can see that it's set to surface. Inventor does this automatically if you do not have a closed sketch. So I'll go ahead and switch this to solid. Now once I've done that, I still cannot select inside the shape, but the red little plus sign pops up to allow me to examine my problem. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. That will bring up my sketch doctor. And in the sketch doctor, it's telling me that there are no valid closed loops. So I'll go ahead and click next. And it's telling me that I can do a couple of different things. I can go and edit the sketch, or I can diagnose the sketch. Now, if I know exactly where the problem is, I can go ahead and click Edit Sketch and then get right into the sketch and fix it. But I'm still not sure where the problem is. I have several different vertices, and rather than go and check them independently, I'm going to diagnose this sketch. So I'll select that option, then click Finish. You can see that the Diagnose Sketch dialog box pops up, and it's looking for several different issues here. I'm just going to go ahead and accept them all and click OK. And as we can see, it found the open loop for me, and we can see the little green dots down here in the lower left corner. So that saves me from having to go in and figure out where my problem is. I'll go ahead and click next. It tells me it found an open loop. I'll go ahead and click next again. And I can choose close loop, and it'll automatically close it. The problem I have with that though is I don't know exactly how it's going to constrain and what the actual issue is. So personally, I like to go and edit the sketch. So I'll edit sketch, finish, click OK to get back to the sketching environment. I'll go ahead and zoom into the lower left corner here since I know that's where the problem is. And I'll select one of my segments, and it looks like we're missing a coincident constraint here. I can even drag these two endpoints apart. So I'm going to go ahead and add a coincident constraint between the two endpoints here. Now I can see that my sketch actually changed colors. It's fully constrained. I should now be able to go ahead and revolve or extrude the shape to make a solid. Next, we'll take a look at a feature problem. Here I currently have an extrusion cutting through this rectangular shape, and if I edit this extrusion, I can see that it's been created to go to a selected face. And we can see that selected face is the back face here. We're going to change the diameter of this hole. I'm going to edit the sketch and double it to 50. As you can see, the hole is actually coming off of the shape now. So when I click finish, I get a little error message here. It lets me know that some errors occurred. I'll go ahead and expand this plus sign here to learn more. Tells me it couldn't build the extrusion. Again, I'll expand it. And here it's telling me that the attempted operation did not terminate the tool body completely by the specified termination plane. So what does that mean? It means that I told this to extrude to that back surface, but the shape actually extends past the surface now, so it cannot terminate on that surface. Now, if I know what the problem is, I can go ahead and cancel and go and fix it. I can also click the red plus sign here to start the recover command. I'll click yes here. As you can see, it brings up my design doctor. It's telling me I had a modeling failure, so I'll select that and click next to learn more. Once again, it's telling me that I've got this issue where it didn't terminate, so I'll go ahead and click next again. Then I can decide, what do I want to do? Do I want to delete this feature or suppress it? Well, I don't want to do either of those things. I actually want to fix the hole. So with Edit Extruded Feature selected, I'll click Finish. It brings up the Extrude dialog box here. And there's a couple of different ways that I can fix this. I could change the depth to a distance instead, but I really want to tie it to that back surface. So I'm going to use this option right here to extend basically that end face. Then I can go ahead and click OK. And now you can see that I have fixed the problem. So if you have some sketching issues or modeling issues, try out the Sketch Doctor and Design Doctor tools. Hopefully they can help you pinpoint exactly where your problem is. That concludes this look at fixing sketch and feature problems in Autodesk Inventor.